Today we're going to show Figma Make that was announced in the latest Figma config as beta and compare it to Anima and discuss diffs and why they're important as a way to differentiate between the solutions in this space. We'll use the layout that you should know by now of the landing page. Just right click, copy, and then in Figma Make, Control V. For best results, try pasting a less complex design. It's a landing page. Not sure why it's a complex design, but let's see what's going on. Build website based on design. That was fairly quick. Looks good. Now, let's move to the interesting bit. We'll start by looking at the design that we imported. See, it looks like the design that we know. Same thing with Anima. Looks like the design that we know. Very close. That's great. Now we're going to put in the same instructions. Please make the following changes. Instead of the three buttons on the top right, put four tabs there with the titles Team, Portfolio, Value, and Contact Us. And then where the logos are for Google, Amazon, etc., make it a moving carousel. Gonna press Enter for Anima. We've done this in the past. Do the same exact instructions here. Gonna click and we'll see how it goes. Anima is done. It added Team, Portfolio, Value, and Contact Us, but it didn't get rid of the Get Started. Let's look at here. Give us arrows for us to move it on ourselves, which is not what I wanted, but still interesting. And the rest looks the same. Let's check out Figma Make. Still not done. In the meanwhile, let's say make the carousel move automatically. Also remove the Get Started button. Figma's still not done. Yay, it removed the button. It made the carousel move automatically and it didn't change anything else. See, Figma appeared to be stuck. Oh, so it removed the buttons. It added the tabs that we wanted, made them actionable. The carousel as well, which is moving automatically. Doesn't look great, but it moves. But it dropped everything else. It actually cut most of the landing page. If you look at the Anima implementation, there is a bunch more after the hero part that doesn't exist anymore on the Figma. This is a bit early, but it's actually a good segue to what I wanted to talk about, which is diffs. Diffs means that instead of you creating the website from scratch every time, which wastes token and time and resources, but also creates hallucinations, meaning changes that you did not want or intend to make, you actually change a little bit of the code every time. So even if something is not 100%, you do not screw up everything else. What probably happened here is that Figma Make tried to generate the entire website again with our changes, which generated a massive hallucination, meaning that it forgot the rest of the page, which is not only wasteful on resources, it's destructive. While Anima only changed what we wanted, good, bad, it doesn't matter, but it did not reflect on anything else. So I don't normally do this because I'm not a React expert, but I have to look at the code. If you look at the code in the application, there's little to nothing that actually changes. If you actually look at the things that we've changed, it all points out to this file, landing page modified. It's massive spaghetti code in a way that seems to me like it would be a problem to integrate or even use because it's not sectioned correctly. In contrast, if you look at Anima and you look at their code, you'll see that we changed a lot of files. There are plenty of files that have been changed. So if you look at the logo bar, which is the carousel, you'll see functionality in one thing. And then later we asked it to change the logo bar again because it wanted it to move automatically. So the changes are confined to specific files based on functionality in a way that seemed to be sectioned closer to what we would expect a developer, which makes sense that it will create a superior functionality and reduce the hallucinations and create better differentiation. But again, I'm no expert, so I could be wrong. What do you think? There you have it. We had our first experience with Figma Make, and we learned something about diffs. Hopefully it was fun for you. Stay tuned.